Ismail, thank you so much for joining us today. As the virus hit, you and your team made this incredible decision to pivot the business. Tell me how you boosted capacity to be able to produce the masks that you're making today, and take me inside this decision to start producing masks in the first place.
Thank you very much. Good morning, and thanks for having me. So the idea started a couple of months ago. Mubadala launched a number of initiatives under a campaign called We Are Determined. The purpose of this campaign is to bring opportunities and bring initiatives actually to support our first line of defense here in the UAE and around the world. Mubadala's CEO, His Excellency Khaldun al-Mubarak, had a phone call with the CEO of Honeywell. And within 30 days of that phone call, we were able actually to stand up an N95 production lines here in our facilities in LA with a capacity of producing around 30 million masks annually. We've started by providing these masks for our first line of defense here in the UAE, and actually we have made some international sales. For example, Japan and the UK are using our masks today.
And the aviation industry has been crippled by this pandemic. Interestingly, you're the first production line for N95 masks in the Gulf region. You mentioned that the bulk of the production is so far catering to domestic demand, but give me some more insights into how you expect to continue to make these masks and to sell them internationally. What's the opportunity for Strata?
The opportunity is great. When we looked at the region, actually, there is a requirement for almost 500 million masks over the next 5 years. We don't want to be serving the UAE only, we want to expand also. So from our perspective, we want to do 80-20. 80% of our production will serve beyond the borders of the UAE, while 20% only will be to cater for the demand here at the UAE.
If you're eyeing those export markets, where specifically then are you targeting?
We are actually talking to a number of countries around the world. In the Far East, as I've said, we were able to do our first sale in Japan. We are talking to a number of countries here in the region, a number of European countries, as well as countries in North America.
I know that you employ a significant number of women in the UAE in your manufacturing facility. Do you see that as a growing proposition for your business?
One of the core pillars of Strata is actually to develop a local pipeline of talented individuals to join our activities. Over the past decade of our operations, we were able actually to hire around 60% UAE nationals, out of which 89% are actually women. Toward the end of this week, we will be celebrating the Emirati Women's Day, and we are proud that Strata is an example of actually providing opportunities for ladies. Strata is an example not only here in the UAE, but worldwide. When it comes to the aerospace industry, it's a male-dominated industry. We were able actually to break through and provide more opportunities for ladies. I'm very proud that 30% of my leadership team are actually talented female. When you go down also, 60% of our supervisors, 60% of our team leaders are female.
And Ismail, you should be commended for that achievement. I mentioned before that, of course, the aerospace manufacturing industry has been hurt hard by this pandemic. Normally, if we were in pre-COVID times, you would be making parts and supplies for manufacturers like Boeing and Airbus. How soon do you expect to return to normal operations, or will you be pivoting to masks longer term?
Well, from our perspective, if you look at what happened with this pandemic, the humanitarian, the social, the fiscal, as well as the economic impact has been of historic proportions. The aviation industry has been one of the first hard hit industries when borders closed. Two-thirds of the worldwide fleets of aircrafts has been parked for now 3-4 months. We've seen occupancy drop to below 5%. This actually affected Strata. So we've looked at utilizing our opportunities. We've looked at utilizing the excellent facility that we have. We looked at utilizing the talent that we have, our technicians, our engineers, my colleagues, the admin staff, and pivot into new areas. PPE was the first one, and we continue to investigate and look for new opportunities, especially in the area or the sector of medtech.
We have to wrap it up there. Thank you very much for joining us, Ismail Ali Abdallah from Strata Manufacturing. Good work there as well. Thanks very much for joining us.